growth gives you the most commonest measure of economic performance. Employment gives you another dimension because it gives you an indication of how productive we are. Historical data, economic growth, unemployment data, and per capita income. What are the Nigerian long-term problems that we see? And we can identify three of them. The first one is that, how do we actually foster sustainable growth over a long period of time? And when I say sustainable growth over a long period of time, there are two characteristics or there are two features that are required. The first one is that this growth must not be dependent on oil prices. That's the first one. The second one is that, which is also related to not dependent on oil prices, there has to be some underlying productivity changes that are driving this growth. But what we see when it is dependent on oil prices is that most of you, I don't want to bore you with this calculation, but if you look at productivity, it is output divided by input. But what usually changes in relation to oil price changes is that the Y on top just keep changing without any underlying changes in actually input. And when I mean by input, meaning the way in which we do things, or the changes in the input mix, it does nothing changes, just the prices and the income at the top. So, how do we foster sustainable growth over a long period of time? That is not dependent on oil prices, that's the first question. The second one is, how do we now make sure this growth also translates to broad-based increase in income for generality of Nigerians? Now, if you look at the 2000 to 2014, some people became multi-billionaires in Nigeria, right? So when you see annualized increase of per capita income of about 16%, some people's annualized per capita income actually went down. So it's not everyone that actually benefited from the increase in the income that came from increases in oil prices. So the second question, long-term problem that we have and we must address it is, how do we ensure this, any growth, the income that comes, translate to broad-based increase in incomes for majority of Nigerians? And of course, the third one, because we are a large population country, we are 180 million people. We cannot model our economy after Saudi Arabia. We cannot. Because even if you give people incomes and you don't give them job to do, there will still be social crisis. So we must also ask the question and answer, hopefully, how do we create enough jobs for the millions of Nigerians entering the job market? Those of us, I believe most of us that are here, I believe we have jobs. But even if you have jobs, and no matter who you are, and any minister, anyone that become a minister or the head of an agency will tell you, the major problem they have, apart from running their agency or their ministry, is the number of applications and CVs that they receive to deal with. Everyone has done that. I went to the office of a minister one day. The pile of CVs, I mean, it was too much. So if he has to deal with all those CVs, he will not do the work. So no matter how much income and no matter how rich we are, we need to look for jobs for those entering the jobs market. So that's a third long-term problem we need to solve. So now, when we talk about these long-term problems, what is the response that we should have? Or what is the tool that economic policy has given us to solve these problems? The tool that economic policy has given us to solve most of this problem is fiscal. Fiscal policy and expenditure. Meaning, the way government spends money is very important to solving these long-term problems. The way government spends money and how much government spends is very important, and that's just simply fiscal policy. So, let's do some analysis of how previous governments or previous administrations have tried to solve this problem, looking at it through the perspective of the budget. Next slide. So, the graph that you see that gives you the history of Nigeria's budget from 2006 to 2015. And this is not for the faint hearted. Looking at this data, if you don't have art, please move, just look away now. The first bar that you see for each year is the revenue, and the second bar is for the expenditure. So, let me just quickly tell you. The government, the first bar that you see, just the first, I'm not very good with colors, but the first bar that you see is government revenue, and the large chunk of that revenue is oil revenue. Now, it shows consistently over, I'm talking about federal budget by the way, not a combined federal state, no, just this federal budget. Now, the second bar for each year shows the expenditure. It shows the expenditure. Now, what you quickly, the properties that you quickly observe is the one, Nigeria, next slide, no, sorry. Nigeria is heavily dependent on oil revenues, I mean federal government. And from the second bar, what you quickly notice is that this same oil revenue, which is the darker blue aspect, is used for recurrent expenditure. That's what the data shows. I did not manufacture this data. So, you have the second bar, the darker blue is recurrent expenditure. Now, the lighter blue is capital expenditure. And the third one on top of that is other kind of expenditure, including servicing of debts. So, what does this also tell us? What else can we learn from here? It is that a significant chunk of what we receive as our revenue is spent on recurrent expenditure. Before I give you more details on that, next slide. Let's just do a quick comparison of Nigeria's 2016 budget to other countries in terms of per capita. And you will look at Nigeria as the first bar, India the second bar, South Africa, China. So you see how the difference, this difference in per capita expenditure of this central government. Now let me look at the next slide. Now, so let me continue my story. Government is heavily dependent on oil revenue, although it has reduced slightly in recent years because taxation has started to go up. But it is still majority of our revenue still come from oil. And the second feature of the data that we saw is that even when government enjoys high revenues, from that 2000 to 2014 that I told you about, deficits continued to rise. Because as more income comes, there's an appetite to even spend more. The top thing is that most of the increase in spending during this period went to recurrent expenditure, and I think I mentioned that. And that went up by 197% between 2016 and 2015 compared to capital expenditure increases of just 48%. And this is for a country that has those very long-term problems that I identified. So other expenditure mostly, which is debt servicing, I mean, which has also been increasing because as we incur debt, you have to service this debt, you have to pay back. So consequently, we have a fiscal expenditure structure that has been a drag on future growth, not necessarily on present growth, but if you're talking on growth in the future, it's been a drag.